Nanomaterials are used extensively in consumer products, things like electronics, in water treatment. They're used in agriculture. And for 10 years, we've been studying their fate and behavior. And we've learned that nanomaterials aren't toxic just because they're small. We've made a lot of progress in understanding, but there's still some open questions that have to be addressed. Very few studies have been done to look at how these engineered nanomaterials behave in very complex environments. Many of those studies have been done in laboratory environments and controlled systems. The reality is these materials are going to be released into a natural system. So one of the things that we've done in our center is we've created this mesocosm facility. We have 30 boxes that are about a couple cubic meters per box, and they represent a freshwater emergent wetland. So there's water, there's soil, there's sediment, there's plants, there's organisms. And we were able in this study to add gold nanoparticles at very low doses, and we could see how they were behaving in a real ecosystem. And we selected gold nanoparticles because they're inert, a particle that wouldn't transform or change in any way, and we could track where those particles went in the environment. It turned out that they transformed quite a bit. This particular study showed that the organisms living on a subaquatic plant were collecting the nanoparticles and then transforming them by releasing cyanide. And we look at how the system components, in this case, the bacteria living on these aquatic plants, were transforming the materials and making them available to the plants.
So what we have seen after 6 months was that more than 70% of the gold that we added in the mesocosms were associated with the aquatic plants. We realized that these aquatic plants were covered with biofilm, and a biofilm is basically a community of microorganisms that lives in this viscous matrix that helps them to stick to surfaces. And we realized that after a couple of weeks, more than half of the gold that we added to this biofilm was dissolved.
Now that we have this understanding, we should be able to take that knowledge and apply it to beneficial uses of nanomaterials. So one example could be taking advantage of the phytobiome on plants and their abilities to transform materials to deliver agrochemicals better. It's going to take more time to really look at the various systems and learn how to leverage them and take advantage of them, in particular the microbiome. But this study shows that that is possible and opens the door now to trying to understand the complex relationships between the different components of the ecosystem and the nanomaterials and how to benefit from them.